Sugar Shane Mosley used to be all business on the entrance, but as part of his new superstar profile, Mosley feels compelled to adopt the form of presentation that's become popular in other corners of the sport, and he will enter preceded by a live rap performance.
Drop bows on him. Everybody out to sit right now. What's up? We gon' throw them bows. Sugar Shane or the Chris. Shannon Taylor, you won't be throwing no bows. Cadillac grill, Cadillac bill. Check out the whole my Cadillac spill.
Shannon Taylor had had so many street and bar fights, his reaction was, that means he drinks, and that means he has bad hands. And in fact, Taylor has broken his right hand in his last three fights.
Taylor calls them gravel hands, says he scrapes them on the gravel as he punches the guy into the ground. Taylor has said in pre-fight publicity, I'll die to win the fight. Mosley says, no, no, he won't have to do that. I hit him, he falls down, they count him out. It's a lot simpler than that.
Yeah, we gon' throw them blows. Drop blows on them. Drop blows on them. What? Drop blows on them.
Mosley's son and two nephews precede him into the ring. For Sugar Shane, unblemished, 36 wins, no losses, no draws, 33 KOs, the former dominant lightweight champion who jumped 12 pounds, beat De La Hoya, and added the welterweight title to his dossier. And now let's go to ring announcer Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Caesar's Palace, Las Vegas, Nevada, Cedric Kushner Productions, in association with your undisputed, undefeated king of beers, Budweiser. Always proud to be your bud. Present 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Welterweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, the three judges assigned to ringside are Bob Logis, Larry O'Connell, and Jerry Roth. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Vic Draculich. And now, from the site where legends are made, Caesar's Palace, Las Vegas, Nevada. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black and weighing in at an even 147 pounds. His professional record, 29 bouts without a loss. He has 18 knockouts in his 28 victories, and one contest went to a draw. He's traveled here from the land down under, from New South Wales, Australia. And he has one goal tonight, to shock the world and go home with the title. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the undefeated challenger, ranked number one in the world by the WBC, Shannon, the Bull Live Lester Taylor. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing gold, trimmed with black. He also weighs in at 147 pounds. His professional record, a perfect one, consisting of 36 bouts, 36 victories, including 33 knockouts. His KO percentage is the highest of any active champion today and one of the best in boxing history. That's why he is considered by many as, pound for pound, the best fighter in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, from Pomona, California, presenting the two-time world champion, the reigning and defending undefeated WBC welterweight champion of the world, Sugar Shane.
Out of the ring, let's go.
Okay.
second.
All right, gentlemen, this is for the WBC welterweight title. You've received your instructions. Again, I want to caution you. Hitting you there below here, it's going to be a low blow. Same over here. With that said, at this time, are there any questions? Any questions, Chief Seconds?
Well, I just want to have a clean fight. I don't want any rough house and hit behind the heads and all that kind of stuff, pushing down and things like that.
We're going to have a clean fight here.
Oh, no, gentlemen.
Remember, obey my commands, protect yourselves at all times.
Good luck to both of you.
All right.
Okay, thanks.
This is the ultimate in reality TV. You couldn't make up a character like Shannon Taylor. You couldn't make up a fighter like Shane Mosley. Have we ever had a Shane versus a Shannon before, Jim?
So you're thinking that the question here is whether the Australian will survive his trip to the United States?
Well, you pointed out that he's a big underdog to win the fight, but the odds are actually even that the fight goes the distance. So there is some respect out there for him.
I think there's a lot of respect for his strength. He's obviously a sturdy guy, and he is a willing fighter if ever there's been one.
Said he's willing to die there if he can just be willing to think tonight. He can do a lot better than people expect. Use your reach. Use your jab. Whenever you get hit, don't try to pay him back. Just keep your superior reach.
Crowd hooing and eyeing at Mosley's hand speed as he landed a 1-2 combination. Taylor trying to keep his gloves up around his face. And Mosley, if he keeps looking at this, will eventually go to the left hook to the body, which is one of his primary weapons.
What Mosley is trying to do is discourage the longer arm guy from jabbing. So if he doesn't get discouraged and keeps up with his left jab, he can take over.
George, Shannon Taylor is a little taller, but actually Mosley has a longer reach. So I don't know how that.
Well, watch when they jab. Just watch when they jab. Don't worry about the number. Just look when Taylor throws his jab, Mosley throws his. Who connects? Just watch.
Taylor stepping in behind his jab there.
He's got the jab advantage. The reach is on his side because he turns his left side, and that gives him a little more.
That's a good point, George. Shane fights with his shoulders a little bit more square.
You got to look at it. Don't just watch the numbers. Mosley seems to take away everything he has thus far by discouraging him when hitting as soon as he finishes. You can tell when a boxer does not want you to jab, he'll start throwing right hands on top of your jab. Keep the jab up, keep the jab in the rope, and all kinds of things for Taylor.
Taylor getting in with a right hand, Mosley left hooking in return. Right hand lands for Taylor.
All because he was able to start with those jabs. Getting Shane Mosley prepared to duck from his right left jab, throw the right hand.
Mosley popping the jab off the chin of Taylor.
Mosley so slick.
Sugar, various critics have gone so far as to compare Mosley's style to that of Sugar Ray Robinson, and there's one of the reasons why. Lightning power.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Over here.
Over here.
Watch
it.
Round comes to a close. Blood trickles from the right nostril of Shannon Taylor. Shane Mosley got it. Got it. And took advantage.
Where you had the critical clicks 10 seconds before the end of the round, that Taylor relaxed and got dropped.
Shannon, you okay? Shannon, listen to me. How are you, Shannon? Be honest, Shannon.
I didn't know, yeah.
Just as the 10-second warning sounded, it seemed that Taylor may have relaxed a fraction